Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? Yep, we've got another busy week. We've always got a busy week, I seem to say that every time. So yes, we do actually have a busy week, again. The question that I asked you last week was this one here. Hang on, let me go through, and forestry equipment, that's what I'm looking for. So the Fliegl Timber Runner, £17,000 if we want to buy it. This is one that has an auto load script, and I asked you if you wanted me to get one with an auto load script or just stick to the game standard one, and everybody has said I can use one with the auto load because then we can speed things up a little bit later on. So thank you for that, and we will be using it. And my question for this week is, I'm going to be doing very soon, not quite yet, but I will be doing soon a whole load of silage and haymaking. And what I have not done yet is do whole crop. I know I use the whole crop header on harvesting some grass over here, but what I haven't done is actually harvest some crops. So I finished field 42, by the way. That one's all done, and the greenhouses there are all full as well. But yeah, what I haven't done is actually harvest whole crop and turn it straight into silage. So I'm seriously considering either field 5 or field 22, probably. I don't know which one. I don't think we'll do that one. Probably this one, because we can come out and tip it up here, or straight down and into the... I don't know, but anyway. Do you want me to do a bit of whole crop silage? And I won't... Obviously, we got rid of forage harvester. That one, the Rossel mash. We got rid of that one. So we'll be using a different forage harvester, and I thought I had one here somewhere. Apparently I don't. I really did think that I had another one. Where's that one gone? Maybe it's in the miscellaneous? Apparently I don't have another one, but I thought I did. But anyway, if I don't, I'll just use the game standard one. I will be using another forage harvester, and we will get going with that. So do you want me to do any whole crop silage? Or do you want me to just stick with grass and combine the whole crops? It's your vote. It's your game. Head down below and let me know what you want to do. So this week we are going to be doing something rather different. And I was talking about it last week. I've put a bit of extra silage in for the cows. You can see their silage is now at 7,000. I've only got 1,700 in for the straw. So I will put more straw in soon, but I don't think I'm going to do that this episode. What I have done is I've hired a whole host of machinery, and we're going to be doing forestry work this week. And if we take a look at the map again... I don't want to go that one. I'll go back here. So we've got a patch of forestry here, and there, we sell the wood up here, right? It's sold up here at the shop. So we've got a patch of forestry here, and we got more over here, which is closer to the farm, but... this bit of forestry here is actually a lot more accessible because there's a road that runs down here and it runs straight into the forest. So we could go from there, travel straight up here and along that road, and then we could sell the wood. It's going to be closer. So, but on the other hand, we got all the gear down here. I do have transport machine. I've got things to transport it around. You know, I think we're going to go up there anyway. We'll go all the way up round and up to this bit of forestry, and then we can take a look at that. So I've got this lorry here. This is one that I've not used before, which is the Tatra Phoenix, and that one's turned up in yellow. You don't get to pick the color when you hire them. And we've got the Ponzi Scorpion. They're ready to go. Now, this log fork that I've got is actually one in the mod section, and I don't remember actually installing it. I'm not sure what is different about this one. It might be one that slightly extends on the top so you can pick up more logs. I'm not quite sure. We will find out. But anyway, let's get this lorry started up. And if we leap in here, start this one up. There we go. And take a look in the cab a minute. Nicely done. Fairly basic lorry, but it's got everything that you need. Where's the gear stick? Is that the gear stick there? Is that a digital gear stick? Wow. Okay, I've never seen that before. Right. I'll leave the log trailer here a second, because this episode we're not going to do much. You see that? It's got rear wheel steer on this one. The rear wheel is actually steering slightly. That's actually really cool for maneuverability. That is going to really help. Now, can I load... so you can hitch that one from here. But you can't... obviously, with the tractors now, it hitches a bit differently, doesn't it? So let's unfold that one. Lower that one down. And I'm going to put on here, I want to put the loader, and I want to put the Ponzi Scorpion. So I'll put the Scorpion on here first. Let's climb into this bad boy. Take a look inside, take a look around the cab. I know most of you have seen this before, so I won't do this very long. There we go. There's the cab. Everything's looking grand. And we'll see if we can do this from inside the cab. I'm not hopeful about this. We might be able to. We'll see. Probably have to come out of the cab to do this so I can line it up properly. It's not going to be very easy otherwise. I can line it up here easy enough, but it's getting it up to that top bit. Wondering if I should get the loader on here first. Use the JCB. Get that log fork hitched onto it and bring that one up. Okay, I'm going to have to come out of the cab. Oop, not that one. There. Can I even fit this and... Yeah, see, I can't go any further. And I'm not going to be able to fit the JCB on here as well. So I think we'll go and get the JCB. If I just move this one over here a second. Drop that one there. Right, now let's run over here. I know that I've sort of left machinery strewn around the yard in here. But we'll just live with that for now. It can stay there. I finished up with that tractor and brought it back after I got the greenhouses sorted out. I did sell a bit more silage as well. I haven't sold all of it. I've still got about 20-odd thousand litres left. But I'm going to sort of save that for a minute because I don't know when the next lot of silage is going to be finished. So we might still need that. Now, I'll come into cab for this. Go and get that log fork, and then we'll get this one squeezed up as high as we can. I think we'll drive this one on forwards, so that, and the log fork is pointing forwards. Get it as out of the way as we possibly can. Right, come up here slowly and steadily. There we go. Load that one on. Now, what is the control for this? Just see what this one's about. Up and down, yeah. That opens. Or is it just a... Oh, I think it's just a little bit longer, actually. I think it's just got a slightly longer curl on it. Because there's nothing else on it. I'm doing both mouse buttons together. That's not giving me anything. So, yeah, it just... I think it's actually just a slightly longer curl on the front. Which aids with scooping up logs. You can get, I think you can actually accumulate just a couple extra. Compared to what you would normally be able to... I don't think I'm going to be able to get the Scorpion and this one on the same load. I just don't think it's going to be an option, is it? Ooh. Yeah, see? I can get up there like that. Put that one up in the air. That's not a good way to drive around with that stuck up like that. And I don't think the Scorpion is going to get on the back anyway. I think we're going to just have to go twice. Which is a little... That's not really the whole... The idea of this low loader was that we would be able to transport it all in one go. Right. If that's the case, what we'll do is we'll just take this one. Let's switch you off. And we'll take this one up to the field. Right, I want to close the gates up. So we'll do this journey. I'm going to do this out of cab for this one. So that we can see it getting out around the yard. I've got to get through the yard yet. And then the next one, I'll come back and I'll grab the Ponzi Scorpion. Because once you've seen one trip, you've seen them all. And then we can get started on cutting some trees down. Right. And let's squeeze out around here. This is not easy. But I think it's going to fit. Just squeeze past the straw up there. There we go. Right. So that's fit there. And now I got to get out on here now. I need to put my beacons on. There we go. Have I got... Oh, I got rear beacons as well. Excellent. And indicate would be good. Right, there's nothing coming that way. There is a car up there, but I think we can get out round before he gets down here. There we go. I'll turn my indicator off. Now I'll come in cab. Do this. Good. Steering's on the wrong side of the lorry for this. It's a... import rather than a native UK one. No, what am I talking? Yeah, it is on the wrong side. For a second there, I thought it wasn't on the wrong side and it's supposed to be on the outside, but no, it's definitely not. I'm so used to driving machines in this game on the sort of on the wrong side of the road, but a moment there I got confused. It does happen. It happens frequently, I know. Right, so we'll come up here, and then we got to turn off just here. I very rarely actually show you an entire journey when I'm taking stuff around. I just sort of cut from beginning to end, so it will make a bit of a change. I know it's not the most exciting thing to happen, is to just drive along the roads, but at least it sort of gives you like an idea of what the place looks like, if you don't always get to see it. So we're staying in cab for this. I'll come out of cab so we can see it going across the bridge just up here. It's not that far back. Up, rather. And there's, just coming up on our right, there is the root storage yard up there. So we've got the field there. We don't own that field. We did cut through there back when we were trying to find water up here. That's the entrance to the root storage yard. And then just here is the bridge. Just coming up now over the top of this little brow of this hill here. So if I pop out of cab a second, it's just going across the bridge. There we go. Beacon's going. That is a fantastic picture. Look at that. That really does look good. I like that. Right. Moving on. So there's a road here on the right, just up ahead. And I can't actually remember where it is. I do remember seeing... Oh, there it is. And I've never actually been down this road. I've been past it many times, but I have never been past it. So I'm coming out of cab again for this. Let's see how much we cut into the hedge. A little bit, actually. If we have full collision on the hedges, I think that would have been successful anyway. Sometimes when we do things here, we do sort of cut through the hedges a bit, and you sort of think, yeah, if we'd had full collision there, that would have been a complete disaster. I'm just going to get rid of some of these boxes on our screen for a second. And having never been along this road before, this is all new stuff to me. I did sort of briefly, I think, have a look around when I first got onto this map, but I didn't really come down here very much. I know that you come down here to get to the trees, the forest. We got fields on either side of us, quite long fields, actually. Field 39 in now. I would like to get some more, but before, I don't think I'm going to buy all the fields before we finish playing this map, because once you get above a certain sort of scale when you're doing a let's play, it kind of gets a little bit dull, I think. Kind of wears out, and you've seen it all before, you've seen it on the map all before, so you end up not getting anything new, anything decent. Now, this is going to be a bit of an issue, is I've got to be able to turn round. I've got to unload this thing, then I've got to be able to turn round and get this lorry out of here. I'm hoping that I can turn round in the trees down here somewhere. I didn't think about this, did I? Right, first of all, let's just go on a little bit further. Just a little bit more, there we go, so that I can stop and... Yeah, unload the back. Can I... Let's keep unloading while I'm... No, I've got to be in cab for it to finish it. There. Yeah, that one. And now if I come up here a second, climb into this one, start her up. That up, back off of it, and then we've got to be able to turn round. This is not going to be particularly easy, and what I'll do, as soon as I got the scorpion up here, we can start chopping the trees, and I'll cut a whole load of these trees right here in the entrance so that we've got plenty of room to maneuver, because I'm going to need to be able to, I'm going to move this one over here a minute, because I'm not going to be using this one just yet. That's just up here ready. Ooh, there we go, shut you off. Now I'll come over here, and we've got to find a way to turn round. That's going to be the difficult bit. There we go, and shut that one up. Right. While that's shutting up, I think I'd just go on down here a little bit further, and I've got room to spin round, I'm hoping. Just need to try and find a little bit of space. I think I can do it there, in between those trees. This is all well and good being able to back up, but you still need to be able to actually turn to get out. And I don't want to hit the trees. Turn a bit there. Having the extra maneuverability on this lorry does actually make it more suited for forestry work, doesn't it? There we go. Right, I'm actually right close to field 42. Can't get out that way, though. I've got to go round the long way, but we've turned now. There we go. So that means I can get back down to the main yard, and I'll load the Ponzi Scorpion, and I'll bring that one up, and then once I've got that one up here, we can see about starting to cut a few trees down. I'm just pulling in now with the Ponzi Scorpion. I'm going to drive the lorry down a little bit further. Just get around that tree a bit there. So then I can back the Scorpion up and we can start removing a whole load of trees. There we go. I think that's far enough. So if I just lower that one down and then I'll shut the lorry off here. There. Get into this Scorpion and we can get started on this. I'm going to do maximum length trees. You see the way that flicked over that? I do like the self-leveling on this thing. It is very cool. Now, the only thing that I do have to do is I will be using a mouse for the controls for this one because I don't have two joysticks linked up together to do that. A little bit of a shame, but that's okay. It's quite a bit to set all of that up and it doesn't really detract from my gaming experience to do it like this. So, we'll go in here. I'm going to try and... No, I don't want to do that. I wanted to do that one. There. Right, I'm going to try and do this from inside the cab to start with. So we turn it on first. There we go. Right, change the cut length. This one will go up to 8 metres. That's maximum. So it's not like the one that we had on old times. That one will do up to 15 metres. So we'll do 8 metre lengths on this one. And... Right. I'm going to come down low when we cut them. And let's extend out a little bit. It's extremely difficult to do this from inside the cab. I've always found this extremely difficult to do inside the cab. And that is actually close enough to cut there. So let's grab that one. And then you swing it over here. And I'm going to try and put a few of the logs, sort of pile them up over here to start with. So let's, right, now we need to cut again. I can turn that off now. I remember how to do it. There's one. You either get, I think it's either 2, 3, or 4 lengths from a tree, I think. Right, so there's one tree. Oops. if I was to do that too often, that would be the end of this machine. Okay, let's come out of the cab, because we can... All right, we'll try one from this view. We'll do one from this view, and a little bit further down. Yeah, I've just touched the tree there. I've helped the machine move. Yeah, there we go. I've picked that one up. And bring that back over here as well. Just bring it to that edge of the pile there. And then cut. Excellent. I am curious how much we're going to get for these logs. Because I hardly ever play on normal. I've never actually sold logs on normal. And I know that it does really well, even on hard mode. And I was thinking that we're going to do quite a few trees. Because... What I'd like to do, right, I've done one on that view, so let's do one on this view as well. What I would like to do is get 2 trailerfuls of logs. I think that would be about right. I've got everything up here for this episode. So for the next episode, I'm going to mostly be cutting trees. And we'll cut a whole load of them. And I'll probably jump ahead to finishing cutting them. And... We can start moving some stuff around with the log fork, and then our final episode of this week, we will sell the logs up at the sawmill, and I may sort of chuck in a few extra little bits and pieces to do as well. Not quite sure yet. Because I know there's other things that we need to do. I've got more drilling that I need to get done, and there's a few other bits and pieces I need to do as well. So there's 3. I'm actually running out of time now. I am getting close to the end of this episode. So I apologise if you didn't want to just see me driving around, because I didn't do a huge amount other than just the driving around. So apologise for that if that really wasn't your scene. Tomorrow we're going to be in here in the trees and doing a whole load. And I hope that that is a little bit more what you want to see if you weren't happy today. But there we go. Things change. I try to do sort of something for everybody, and you know, different people like different things. So anyway, the question for this week I'm asking is, do you want me to, when I start doing all my silage and stuff in a week or two's time, do you want me to have a go at doing a bit of whole crop? Do you want me to get one of the fields of wheat and turn it into, I think it's wheat that we got, wheat or barley, I can't remember, but one of them, I will turn it into, let me just pull that in, there we go. I will turn it into whole crop silage. We'll get the whole crop header and have a go at doing that, because I've never done that, and I think it would be quite interesting to see how that goes. But it's your vote, it's your game. Head down below, let me know what you think. Do you want me to do any whole crop silage? Right, let me just get this last one, and then that is going to be it for this episode. I will, let me pull that one out. If I can move it over there so that it's close to... Actually, I want to come back, because I've got a pile of logs here, and then I got those others at that other angle, haven't I? So, extend that boom out, and I'm bring it over there. There we go. Right, now I'm going to come over here so that we can watch it. There, that's a good angle, I think. So, if you've enjoyed this episode, please head down below and give it your like. And if you really enjoyed it, then please tell your friends all about me. Get them to watch as well. Tomorrow, we're going to be doing a lot more tree felling and probably chucking logs around as well, that sort of thing. You get the general idea. But until then, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye, and see you later.